Hey, what's good, everybody? It's CJ Beats. We're back at it again today. Today, we're going to make a Tekashi 6ix9ine beat in Logic Pro X. I already have my sounds picked out here, primarily what I'm going to be using. I might be adding to it later on, but I'm going to start with some strings here. So I got a string sound. All the sounds that you hear inside of this tutorial are coming from two new packs on frequency.com, one being the Brainstorm, and that's an Omnisphere pack, as well as the Tunnel Visions 2, which is a drum kit, which just recently came out, so go check those out for sure. And so we got some strings, a pad, pluck, synth bass, and then we got some drums here. I'll let you hear the drums. So we got a kick drum, snare, secondary snare, an open hat, another open hat, another open hat, one more open hat, perk sound, and some hi-hats. All right, so, and lastly, of course, the 808. Okay, so let's come up with a nice little melody. I set this to 90 BPM. This is the same tempo as a 6ix9ine song called Billy, and that's sort of the vibe that I'm going for this tutorial. So let's try to recreate that type of vibe. I'm going to try and come up with a quick melody for the strings here. I'm noticing that the strings have a lot of bottom end, so I'm going to bring in an EQ. Take some of that bottom end out because we're going to be using the 808s and the bass lines for those. So maybe something in E minor. So I'm going to record that. One more time. All right, let's see. Double click that. Command A and then Q to quantize. Fix what you need to fix. And I think this one needs to be here too. These could maybe be a little bit longer. Nice, okay. Let's duplicate that, just loop it like this. I'm going to use that same pattern that I just made and have the pad play the same thing. So I'm going to hold Alt down, click and drag this down like so. Okay, so we need to work on the EQ with that sound because it's not matching right. So too much of a high end right there. Take that high end off. Just want elements of that sound. Cool, let's come up with a nice little pluck melody on top of all of that. Bring in my pencil tool, let's draw that in. And let's go ahead and see, this was an E minor, so maybe E flat minor. Let's see here. All right, let's see. Bring in my brush tool. And now, you know, what I'm selecting here will be in the scale quantize, so all those should match up. Fire. Let's bring it over like so. And then maybe to make it change up a little bit, what we'll do is have that pluck sound come in a little differently. So, let's see here. I got it in my head. It's something like... Alright, so... Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. So that's a good start. Let's work on the synth bass now. I need to hear it at a higher octave. Okay. I'm going to play it in a higher octave so I could hear it better, and then I'll just lower it. Take some of that high end off. Oh, that's right. What I wanted to do is drop this down. So I'm going to hit Command A and then Alt Shift and down. Quantize that. Too much low end, so sorry to cut some of it out. Alright, let's go crazy on the drums. So let's use this. Maybe just the strings. And we're gonna put in some drums now. So alright, so let me see if I can put in a quick snare. Alright, so here we go. Okay, now see how those are in different colors? That means they're all in different volumes. I want to bring all the volumes to the same level, so select my note velocity. I got there by hitting this and then going to note velocity. Can't see it right now, but oh, here, note velocity, bring all those up like that. Maybe we could just layer it with that other snare. Bringing the volume down of that second snare though. Selected all of them basically like this. And drag them down. Scale quantize off from here. Alright, so now I'm placing in the kick drum. Shorter so that I could see, like, you know, where I could play stuff better. That needs to be here. And let's do like maybe a roll, a kick roll at the end here. So I'm going to use, let's do like 132 note. pencil tool select or brush tool selected, and then let's do like maybe 1/16. I think it's got to be triplets, so let's do triplets. See, what I'm trying to do is fit it into these two bars basically. Yeah. Too slow. Need like that. So let's fit it into one. Okay. But I feel like we need more kicks. Some of that high end off though. It's overpowering everything. So I'm trying to figure out a pattern for this open hat. Too. Okay. Just two like that. Oops. Cue to quantize those. Volume can lower. Be lower. Okay. Maybe a little louder though. That same pattern on the 808, and let's find the key of the 808, making sure that this 808 is in tune. So I'm going to use the metering and tuner. I'm just going to hit C3 on my keyboard. You can see C is playing, that's good, but it's still a little out of tune. It's leaning to the right, so we could use our fine tune in EXS to fine tune it into key like that. Yeah, it's pretty accurate. All right, so now let's find the key. It was E flat minor, so let's double click here. Just bring this to an E flat. Too low though. Still too low. That was now it's a D. Just bring it up. Basses in, you know, up an octave or two, so that you could hear if they're in key or not. So that sounds good. Now we can, like, you know, and then have these maybe go up. Some fast stuff like 132 triplet. And then maybe like 116 triplet. Remove the ones where I'm replacing these rolls with. Didn't sound right. Let's do like maybe 32 normal. Okay. And then do like like 132 triplet. And then do. I'm trying to think here. Let's do 132 regular. Some variation there in terms of where those rolls are. This maybe at the end now. Still something. Okay, so I found this vocal chant. It's a Lex Luger chant that would actually match this type of style. So let me find on my keyboard here. All right, here it is. And let's record that in here. I'm just gonna freestyle it. So, let's see here. Okay, it's two like that, maybe. Maybe we'll have the crashes come in later. Okay, that works. Quantize this, quantize that. Like remove the 808 before it goes into like the pre-hook hook part so that it ends slower or ends faster, I should say, and that will prevent like these two basses from clashing basically. You could, you know, choose to use like choking, it's called group choking, if you wanted to, but this works too. Okay, so there's you see how this is all compact into one, you know, drum kit, drum machine designer. We could basically like count as the amount of sounds we use. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we could just duplicate this eight times. So by hitting Command D on the keyboard, make sure you got 8 of them or 9 of them in total, including the top one. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's one too many, that's fine. So now we're going to select the top one where all the sounds are and separate them by note pitch. Expand it like this and then bring them individually down like so. So now you can like, you know, manipulate the sounds individually. I also like converting my kick from stereo to mono, make it punchier. And some other mixing tricks I'm going to show you now. Sorry for the background noise. And let's see, like that. Got one more. Bring that guy down like this. Perfect. All right, that's what we needed. So now you can, you know, unexpand that, mute it, and bring it to like the top so it's not like in the way. And let's quickly go through all these sounds. So that's our kick. Let's label everything. Make sure you stay organized. Okay, cool. So now we got those all. And now what you can do is give yourself a nice work area and just gonna duplicate these and make sure that they're, you know, in line. Just like building myself a I'm building myself a nice little template that I can like, you know, manipulate. So right now we got all the sounds everywhere, but you know, that's fine for the beginning. Maybe like during like this pre-hook and the hook part, we can take out the kick initially. And maybe some of these open hats can be removed too. Yeah, I like that. So we're gonna remove that here and here too. Okay, cool. So, and then maybe right before the hook drops, we'll have a pause in the drums too. that. And pause in the melody too. Okay. Nice. All right. Do that too, and with the melody too. One more time like this. Okay, so we got an intro, got the pre-hook and the hook, first verse, second hook, second verse, and then second hook. And up until this point, it's only a minute 24. So let's go ahead and just duplicate this whole thing. Highlight it, hit all my keyboard, and then click and drag it over like this. Like 230 is, you know, perfect for a genre. It's like perfect for a song like this. You notice like Tekashi's songs are like a minute, 2 minutes and 19 seconds or less. You know, it makes you hit that play button again and again and again. Smart move. All right, so yeah, let's maybe build in another pause right before the verse drops. So I'm going to bring these in just like that. You could zoom in too to see what you're doing a little better. Okay. The hook and the pre-hook here. Just drop the limiter on it because we're peaking like two, a little bit like two above zero. Some sort of a pause in the melody here too. So maybe something like this. And the drums too. You know, if you pause the drums like that, it's gonna have more of an impact when the verse drops. So let's do it like that. Nice. Okay. So I like that. Since that's pretty much the same, I'm just going to go ahead and reduplicate it. Okay. That's good. Alright, so here we go. Okay, so that kick, I want to, you know, have stand out a little more. So the first thing I'm going to do is convert it to mono. I do this by going to imaging, directional mixer, and stereo. And then we're going to do is just stereo to mono. It's still going to look like it's stereo, but it's actually mono. And I'm going to show you a nice little tool that I use. It's called Sausage Fattener by Data Life, and this will make the kick even thumpier. So we can hit the X real quick on the keyboard to bring up a mixer. I'm gonna solo this out so you could hear it with and without it. So that's with, that's without. Okay, now you can actually lower the volume and still have it punch through that 808 nice. Okay, so let's work on mixing this down a little more, and then we'll get ready to tag it and put a master on it so that we can bring all the volumes up a little bit. So I'm just going to play it back and then maybe pan some of the drums, the hi-hats and stuff. Together. What I'm trying to get at is like -6. All right, cool. So now I can drop in my isotope elements. And this will allow me to, you know, bring up the master volume without distorting, really. Take note of the negative, the RMS over here. That's the perceived volume. So in that point, -0.6 is good. We can bring this down to like -10 dB. That's a good RMS, like -5, -6. Cool, so I'm going to add my tag now, and I'd say this beat is pretty much done in the beginning, right before the bass drops. This might be too loud, so I'm gonna lower the volume.
Forgive me.
Alright, let's make sure that comes in time.
Forgive me.
Supposed to come later. And maybe we could like take some of the sounds out.
Forgive me. Forgive me.
All right, now.
Forgive me.
Yeah, that's nice. Okay, cool. So, it's pretty much done. I'm gonna let it play now, and you guys let me know what you think. As always, I'll put the link in the description for you to download this project.